I'm Andrew Goddard, and these are the top stories for the week ending the 3rd of June, 2022. A new AMD-powered supercomputer, known as Frontier, has been officially recognized as the world's fastest, ranking number one on the top 500 list. Considered the world's first exascale supercomputer, Frontier topped 1.1 exaflops per second, or 1 quintillion computer operations per second, during a sustained benchmark. Not only is that faster than the previous leader, Japan's Fugaku, but it is also faster than the next 7 computers on the list combined. It's hoped that the system, which is based at the US Department of Energy's Oak Ridge National Laboratory in Tennessee, will have a significant impact in critical areas like disease diagnosis, drug discovery, and the manufacture of new materials. BT and Ericsson have reached a multi-million pound agreement to offer commercial 5G private networks in the UK. The multi-year contract, considered the first of its kind in the UK, will pair BT's expertise in building 5G infrastructure with Ericsson's range of network and enterprise products. Target industries include manufacturing, defense, education, retail, healthcare, transport, and logistics. This comes hot on the heels of BT's recent £100 million investment in its Division X unit, which aims to develop advanced customer solutions that integrate 5G, IoT, edge computing, cloud, and AI. Public and private sector companies that have business links with Italy have been told to brace for a new wave of cyber attacks from pro-Russian hackers. Italy's Computer Security Incident Response Team said national public entities like government departments or utility companies are at risk, but also any company with a brand image tied to Italy. The attacks, which are being attributed to pro-Russian hacking group Killnet, follow an attempted cyber attack against the Eurovision Song Contest that was ultimately thwarted by the Italian Incident Response Division. Websites belonging to the Italian Foreign Ministry and the Ministry of Defense were offline as of Monday, and network disruption has been reported by Telecom Italia Mobile. That's it for this week's News in Review, but join us next time for more news from the world of IT.